Good morning, everyone, or good afternoon. It's almost afternoon. It's around 11 o'clock. How are you? I just want to come to you with a message that's been very strong on my spirit, and that message is repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. I am going to start with Matthew chapter 3, verse 1. It was during those days that John the Baptist arrived in the desert of Judah and began proclaiming the message. Turn from your sins to God, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. This is the man Isaiah was talking about when he said, the voice of someone crying out in the desert or in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his path. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Holy One of Israel. Going to verse 4, John wore clothes of camel's hair with leather belt around his waist, and his food was locusts and wild honey. People went out to him from Jerusalem, from all of Judah, and from the whole region around Jordan, confessing their sins. They were baptized by him at the Jordan River. John the Baptist was the forerunner of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ, when he came the first time from heaven as the suffering servant. And his message was repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Some people say, how come they're saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand and earth is still here? We're still living in this present age. Is Jesus Christ ever coming back? You have to remember, as it is written in Psalms 90, verse 4. Remember, this is me talking now. God was never created. He always was. So as it says in Psalm 90, verse 4, 1,000 years to human beings are like a night watch or yesterday to Elohim. That's powerful. So what seems like 1,000 years to you and I seems like or is a night watch or yesterday to Elohim, because he was never created. And remember, John the Baptist was a prophet. And when he said, the kingdom of heaven is at hand, repent, he was speaking under the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the Holy One of Israel. I'm going to go down to verse 11 of chapter 3. It's true that I am baptizing. This is John the Baptist talking. It's true that I'm baptizing you in water so that you may turn from your sins and turn to God. But the one coming after me is more powerful than I. I'm not worthy even to carry his sandals. And he will baptize you with the Ruach HaKadosh, hallelujah, the Holy Spirit and fire. Again, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. I'll tell you something. When I was, I don't remember how old I was, but it was 2011, March 2011. The Holy Spirit aroused me out of my sleep. And I was given this message. And the message that the Ruach HaKadosh spoke to my spirit was, what he said to me was, the great and terrible day of the Lord is at hand. And he said it three times. The great and terrible day of the Lord is at hand. The great and terrible day of the Lord is at hand. And then he asked me, and who shall be able to stand? I had great holy fear and terror as the Holy Spirit was speaking to me. So I was speechless. So he spoke to my spirit and he said, those with a pure heart and clean hands who have not bowed their knees to Baal. And if you read the, I'm having problem again with my computer, but the blood of Jesus. If you read Psalm 24, it will tell you Let me go to it. Psalm 24. My mom passed away from metastatic breast cancer in April 16th, 2011. And one of the scriptures they read was Psalm 24. And I realized that the message that the Ruach HaKodesh gave me was in Psalm 24. And I'm going to find it for you. Bear with me. This is spontaneous. I didn't plan to do this, but it's in my spirit to share it with you. Psalm 24. I love Psalm 24. Almost there, just past it. Okay, Psalm 24, verse 3. Who may go? Now I'm reading from the Complete Jewish Bible. Now, if you read NIV version, it says exactly what the Holy Spirit told me. This is what the Complete Jewish Bible says. Who may go up to the mountain of Adonai? Who can stand in his holy presence? And remember what the Holy Spirit said to me. The great and terrible day of the Lord is at hand. And then he asked me, and who shall be able to stand? And what it says in Psalm 24 is, who may go up to the mountain of Adonai? Who can stand in his holy place? Those with clean hands. Glory to God. You know they got my attention at my mother's. And I'm like, oh my God, hallelujah. That's the same thing that the Ruach HaKodesh told me. Who may go up to the mountain of Adonai? Who shall stand in his holy place? Those with clean hands and a pure heart. Who don't make vanities the purpose of their lives or swear oaths to just to deceive. If you read NIV, it says those who do not worship Baal or bow to false gods. Hallelujah. So let me continue on. Oh, let me finish about my message that the Ruach HaKodesh gave me. So this is what he told me. He said three times, the great and terrible day of the Lord is at hand, and who shall be able to stand? And I had holy fear. I had great holy fear. And I didn't know what to answer. So the Ruach HaKodesh answered me. And he said, those with a pure heart and clean hands who have not bowed their knees to Baal. And then the last thing he said to me was, tell them. I've been telling people ever since. This is my message to the nations. Hallelujah. Well, the time is at hand. We're living in end days. Just look around what's going on around us. I never thought in my wildest dreams that I would ever see homosexuality and lesbian marriages be legalized. But it's legalized. They can now they show homosexuals on television. You know, it's nothing now. It's every day. They took prayer out of school. The world is getting more and more wicked, just like Yeshua told us and warned us in the gospel. If you read the gospel of Matthew chapter 24, the gospel of Luke chapter 21, and Mark 13, they talk about end time signs. And the end time signs are here. Now, no one knows when Yeshua, Jesus the Christ, will come back. Now, if someone tells you that Jesus the Christ will come back and they name a date or a year, don't listen to them because that person has spoken presumptuously and is a false prophet. No one knows when Yeshua HaMashiach will come back. Jesus the Christ. Yeshua HaMashiach is Hebrew for Jesus the Christ. The only one that knows when Yeshua HaMashiach will come back is Abba Father. That knowledge is kept in the mind and heart of Abba Father, but Yeshua did give us signs to look for. And those signs are getting closer and closer. The birth pains are getting closer and closer. War, rumors of war, earthquakes in various places. I have this one video on YouTube where I talk about, I, I'm I live in Maryland. I've never in my life experienced an earthquake in Maryland. In 2011, the summer of 2011, there was an earthquake in Frederick, Maryland, where I was living at the time. And I immediately thought of these scriptures. This is nothing to play with. We need to get right with God. We need to live holy as he called us to live holy. Glory be to God. I'm going to go back to Matthew chapter 3, verse 11 again. It's true that I am baptizing you in water so that you might turn from your sin to God. But the one coming after me is more powerful than I. I am not even worthy to carry his sandals. And he will baptize you in the Ruach HaKodesh and fire. If you read the Bible, you will notice that Jesus Christ never baptized with water. His apostles baptized with water. He didn't baptize with water because this would make this prophecy not true. And this is obviously a true prophet, as we know that John the Baptist had the Ruach HaKodesh when he was in his mother's womb. When his mother Elizabeth talked to Mary, the spirit just leaped in her. This man was filled with the Ruach HaKodesh. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. So if you read the Bible and look at it carefully, Jesus never baptized with water. His apostles baptized with water because his promise was from the Father to baptize believers with the Ruach HaKodesh or the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. Chapter 4 of Matthew, verse 17. From that time on, Yeshua began proclaiming, turn from your sins, repent. Repent to God, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And that is so strong in my spirit. We have got to follow the ways of Yeshua. We have got to live holy. We have got to confess our sins. There is one mediator between human beings and the Father, and that is Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ. We must repent and come to the Father. Jesus did not die in vain. Hallelujah. He was crucified on the cross. This was God's plan for salvation before the beginning of the world. The Ancient of Days knew that that serpent, Satan, would tempt Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. But he had a plan how to bring us back to him. And that plan is that He would come off of his holy and majestic throne. Glory to God. Because God is a spirit. And the spirit can't shed his own blood. And the Bible says, Leviticus 17:11, life is in the blood. And blood is an atonement for your souls. So what did God have to do? He had to get a body. So he took his word, his very essence, and planted into a woman who was highly favored. Glory to God. Yeshua HaMashiach, the word of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Let's look at that first. Let's go to that, because now that's in my spirit. That is John 1:1. This isn't going like I thought it would go. But I'm going to follow as the Holy Spirit is telling me. Amen. Glory be to God. Glory, 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 glory. Anyway, Satan is messing with me because I can't find this, but you know what the Bible says. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Yeshua HaMashiach. The word of God made flesh, because he needed to get a body to shed his holy blood so he can fall down to the ground from whence men were formed. Hallelujah. To cleanse us from our sins. Our sins can only be cleansed by the precious blood of Yeshua, Jesus the Christ. Hallelujah. We cannot be saved by the blood of bulls and goats, but only by the blood of Yeshua. If you do not know Jesus Christ in the pardon of your sins, Come to him today, because he is the only one that can cleanse you from your sins. He is the only one that can give us eternal life. Jesus said, I am the truth, the way, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. Glory, hallelujah. I want to go now to Matthew chapter 24, and I want to start at verse 30, and then I'm going to conclude pretty soon. Okay, I see a lot of people. I want to acknowledge people that I see. Hi, Evelyn. Hi, Melody. God bless you. Bless everyone that's here. Barbara Petty, God bless you. Okay. Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in the sky. All the tribes of the land will mourn, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with a tremendous power, with tremendous power and glory. Glory, hallelujah. He will send out his angels with the great shofar. That's the ram's horn. I'm reading from the complete Jewish Bible. And they will gather together his chosen people, or his elect, from the four winds, from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Now let the fig tree teach you its lesson. When its branches begin to sprout and leaves appear, you know the summer is approaching. In the same way, when you see these things, you are to know that the time is near, right at the door. Okay, I'm going to go up to one. I'm led to go up to verse 1 of Matthew 24. As Yeshua left the temple and was going away, his Talmudim, which is Hebrew for disciples, came and called his attention to the buildings. He answered them, you see all these things? Yes, I tell you. They will be totally destroyed. Not one single stone will be left standing. When he was sitting on the Mount of Olives, the Talmudim came to him privately. Tell us, they said, when will these things happen? And what will be the signs that you are coming? And that this present age or world is ending? Yeshua replied, watch out. Don't let anyone fool you. For many will come in my name, saying, I am the Messiah. How many false messiahs have we heard of in our age? The one that comes to mind, I'm 55 years old, so I remember when I was a little girl, Charles Manson was rampant. I mean, everyone was talking about Charles Manson. He said that he was Jesus. He said he was Jesus, and he had these people killing people. But anyway, that's one false messiah, but there are many more. Glory to God. Yeshua replied, watch out. Don't let anyone fool you. For many will come in my name saying, I am the Messiah. And they will lead many astray. Hallelujah. Reverend Jim Jones coming to mind. David Koresh is coming to mind. Leading all these people astray. How many people committed suicide because of Reverend Jim Jones? Hallelujah. Anybody say they're Jesus Christ? You better run. Run and run fast and far. Hallelujah. Glory to the Most High Elohim. And they will lead many astray. You will hear the noise of wars nearby, the news of wars far off. See to it that you don't become frightened. Such things must happen. But the end is yet to come. For people will fight each other. Nations will fight each other. That's what's happening now. Nations are fighting against nations. And there will be famines and earthquakes in various parts of the world. All this is but the beginning of birth pains or sorrows. At that time, you will be arrested and handed over to be punished and put to death. And all people will hate you because of me. How many people we hear of Christians being put to death in Syria and in other parts of the world? Hallelujah. So all of these signs we see in the present time. And that time, many will be trapped into betraying and hating each other. Many false prophets will appear and fool many. I've heard so many false predictions of when Yeshua will come. I remember they said he would come back in 2012. Someone said he's going to come back in 2000. It goes on and on and on. And this is even before my time. Don't believe them. God said no one will know the hour or the time when the Messiah will return. Yeshua doesn't know. The holy angels doesn't know. Only Abba Father knows. So be ready. Stay alert. keep oiling your lamp like the five wise virgins. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In other words, be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Do the work of an evangelist. Do the work of God. Do what God has called you to do. Live holy. Don't be caught off guard. So when the bridegroom comes, you are not ready. And he will say to you, depart from me. I know you not. Verse 10. At that time, many will be trapped into betraying and hating each other. Many false prophets will appear and fool many. And many people's love will grow cold because of increased distance from the door. But whoever holds out till the end will be delivered. And the good news or the gospel about the kingdom will be announced throughout the whole world as a witness to all the nations. It is at that time the world will end. Now I'm going to go back to verse 32 of Matthew 24. Now let the fig tree teach you its lesson. When its branches begin to sprout and leaves appear, you know that summer is approaching. In the same way, when you see all these things that we just read about, when you see all these things, you are to know that the time is near, right at the door. Yes, I tell you that this people will certainly not pass away before all these things happen. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. But when that day and hour will come, no one knows, not the angels in heaven, not the Son, only the Father. Don't let anyone fool you. Don't let anyone give you a date, a time, an hour. They are speaking presumptuously. And they are not speaking through the Ruach HaKadosh or the Holy One of Israel. They're not speaking through the Holy Spirit, but only through their vain imaginations. Glory to God. For the Son of Man's coming will be just as it was in the days of Noah. Back then, before the flood, people went on eating and drinking, taking wives, becoming wives, right up until the day Noah entered the ark. And they didn't know what happened until the flood came and swept them all away. So get your house in order. Come to Christ now, and I beseech you. If you do not know Jesus Christ, come to him now. He is the only way to salvation. Glory, hallelujah. We cannot be saved except through the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come to Jesus while you still have time. God right now is on his mercy seat. One day he's going to be on his judgment seat. God does not want anyone to be lost. Hell was created for Satan and his angels, not for human beings. Glory to God. God does not want anyone to perish. It will be harder for Jesus to say, depart from me, ye workers of iniquity, than for the sinner to have to hear it. He is giving us time and time, chances and chances to come to him. Please, I beseech you, accept Jesus Christ as your Savior today. Life, heaven and hell are real. Do you not want to reign with the Holy One of Israel, Jesus the Christ, and the prophets? You don't want to go to hell because you have not accepted Jesus Christ and you have not repented of your sins. Walk holy. Bear the fruits of the Spirit. Love. Peace. Patience. Goodness. Meekness. Long suffering. People don't want to hear that. You know, they're taking that out of a lot of Bibles. But it's still in the King James Bible. Long suffering is a fruit of the Spirit, and the fruits of the Spirit are the characteristics of God. And God is long suffering. So indeed, that is a fruit of the Spirit. They took it out of the Bible. But it's still in the King James Bible. And it is a fruit of the Spirit. Pray for long suffering. Pray for faith, more faith, patience. Glory, hallelujah. You can read about the fruits of the Spirit and the works of the flesh in Galatians chapter 5. Okay, I'm going to wind up here. Back then, before the flood, people went on eating and drinking, taking wives and becoming wives, right up until the day Noah entered the ark. And they didn't know what was happening until the flood came and swept them all away. It will be just like that when the Son of Man comes. Then there will be two men in the field. Now listen to this. A couple years ago, I realized what he was talking about. This right here, this is talking about the rapture. Listen to what it's saying. Back then, okay, now wait a minute. This is verse 40, chapter 24. Then there will be two men in the field. One will be taken and one will be left behind. Isn't that what they talk about in the rapture? The word rapture isn't in the Bible, but this is what they're saying. The righteous person, the child of God, will be taken, but the other will be left behind. There will be two women grinding flour at the mill. One will be what? One will be taken, and the other will be left behind. Glory to God. So stay alert, because you do not know what day or hour your Lord will come. You do not know on what day your Lord will come, but you do know this. Have the owners of the house known? Okay, I'm going to stop there. Glory to God. So I pray for all those who do not know Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ, as their Savior. Lord Jesus, I ask you that you prick their heart. Father God, prick their heart, for you said that no one can come to you unless the Father draws them. So Father, I ask you, Holy One of Israel, Abba Father, I ask you to draw souls to you. You have put this on my spirit, lost souls, many, 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 many lost souls. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Hell was not meant. This is so strong in my spirit. Hell was not created for Satan and his angels. Hell was not created for human beings. Hell was created for Satan and his angels. God does not want anyone to perish. He does not want anyone to go to hell. So repent. Glory to God. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Yeshua will come back. We don't know when. Live holy as Abba Father taught us to live holy. Bear good fruit. Read your Bible. Hallelujah. Find a church that teaches the word of God. Doesn't teach about prosperity and getting rich and encouragement. It's okay about encouragement, but you need the word. You need the meat. Find a church that teaches the meat of the word. Find a church that teaches about salvation. Find a church that teaches about hell and that hell is real. Find a church that teaches how you can be saved through Jesus the Christ. The blood of Jesus saves us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Find a Bible teaching church, not a feel-good church or a church that's going to make you tell you that you can get rich or prosperity, sow a seed. That's blasphemy. I've seen where you can buy holy oil and bless yourself and you'll get healed of a disease or whatever. You'll get some kind of miracle. Blasphemy. You think Jesus sold holy oil? The gifts of God are free. Come to God. The Bible says, draw near to God. Draw near to God, James 4, and he will draw near to you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The gifts of God are free. Salvation is free. And you only can be saved through Jesus Christ. So come to him today. I implore you, come to Jesus Christ today. Alpha and the Omega, God in the flesh. Yes, Jesus Christ and God are one. He says they're one. They are one. Hallelujah. He is the Word of God made flesh. Remember, God is a spirit and he needed a body. Because a spirit can't shed his blood. So he sent his word, hallelujah, Jesus the Christ, in the form of in the likeness of sinful flesh. He came the first time as the suffering servant, and his own knew him not. But when he come again, everyone will see him, even those that pierced him. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And he will come in great glory and power. Hallelujah. Blessed be the holy name of God. Thank you, Jesus, for your blood. Thank you for washing us in your blood. Thank you for cleansing us from in your blood. Thank you that by your stripes we are healed. Thank you, Jesus, because he didn't have to come down from heaven. Hallelujah. Glory to God, and walk this filthy earth to save our sins. But he did it because he is love. That's how much God loves us. Hallelujah. Come to God today. Tomorrow is not promised to you. God does not want anyone to perish. He wants all souls to reign with him. And believe me, when he sends a soul to hell, it hurts him more than the person that's going to hell. But remember, they had many opportunities to go to heaven, to hear the gospel. The gospel was being preached all over the world. Hallelujah. Come to God. Come to God. Nothing is worth losing your soul. This earth is temporary. The pleasures of this earth are transitory. But eternal life, that's our goal. And we want our eternal life to be with God in heaven. Hallelujah. We do not want to go to hell. And hell and heaven are real. So repent. That's just so strong in my spirit. So I came here this morning to tell you to repent. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. May God bless you. I love you in the precious name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Christ. Anyone that has any prayer requests, I pray that God answers you. I pray that God heals anyone that's sick. I rebuke the spirit of sickness. I rebuke cancer. I don't know whatever you're going through. I rebuke depression. I rebuke drug addiction. I rebuke all of these things in the name of Jesus. Touch those that are sick in their body. Touch those who are depressed or suicidal. Jesus, hallelujah. You are the great physician. Touch your children right now. Hallelujah. Touch your children, Jesus. Save and deliver souls. Hallelujah. Let this message bless somebody in the name of Jesus. I love you all. God bless you. Shalom. Amen. Bye-bye. God bless you, D-Local. God bless you. Amen.